In this class, we are going to discuss about multiplexers. Multiplexers are very important for gate like technical exams. So, whatever questions they are giving on combinational circuit design, that is mainly on multiplexers only. So, multiplexer is a combinational logic circuit, so which will provide 2 power n inputs to 1 output, that means which will take, which will select one input to output based on selection lines. So, here you can see the description about multiplexer. Multiplexer is a combinational logic circuit used to select only one input line to the output based on the selection lines. So, this can act as a digital switch. So, we can say the input is switched to output based on the selection line. So, here this also called as data selector, which data we need to select at input side that can be decided by the multiplexer, and that is why we are calling this as data selector. And for a MUX, there can be 2 power n inputs and n selection lines and only one output. So, here you can observe the block diagram of multiplexer. So, here generally this is called as 2 power n into 1 MUX. For example, if n is equal to, at least n must be 1. So, here that means at least one input must be there for a multiplexer. So, if n is equal to 1, it will become 2 by 1 MUX then. So, here the number of inputs may be 2 and the remaining, so 2 power n means n place is equal to 1 means here n number of selection lines will be there, that means one selection line will be there and only one output in all cases of all MUXs. So, here in general the MUX is having 2 power n inputs and only one output based on selection lines, that selection lines number may be, so n, that is reference to 2 power n. So, here for example, I am going to take the design of 2 by 1 MUX. So, in the same way we are going to design 4 by 1 MUX, 8 by 1 MUX, 16 by 1 MUX, like that we can design any MUX by using the same procedure. So, for example, I am taking 2 by 1 MUX design. So, this block diagram of 2 by 1 MUX is having, so this is a 2 by 1 MUX. So, I am taking, so 2 by 1 MUX. So, here this is 2 by 1 MUX. So, how many inputs it is having means, so 2 power n place, how much value is there in 2 power n, that many inputs you are having. Here 2 power into 1 MUX, so you are having 2 power n inputs, you can observe. So, you are having 2 power inputs from 0 to 2 power n minus 1. Why? Because if you are having 8 inputs, you are taking from 0 to 7 only. So, that is why. So, if you are having 2 power n inputs, you are having data lines from D0 to D2 power n minus 1. Here, you are having input data lines as 2. That 2 data lines I am considering like D0 and D1. So, here D suffix 2 power n minus 1 means 2 minus 1, so is equivalent to D1. Now, how many selection lines it is having? So, here you just compare the standard MUX with this 2 by 1 MUX. In 2 power n place, you are having 2 here. So, that means n is equal to 1. So, the number of selection lines here is equivalent to 1. Only one selection line is there, that I am taking as S or S0 you can consider. So, here always output of any MUX is equivalent to 1. One output, we are having only one number of output. So, that means that I am taking as Y. So, now this is the time to design truth table for any combinational circuit design. So, like that, I am going to design my truth table for this MUX. So, when you are taking truth table, your first step is to observe the inputs and then you need to take the output for that particular inputs. So, here I am taking my inputs. The inputs for this MUX is D0 and D1. So, here another input is S. So, here with which reference you are taking, with which reference you are going to take y means with s reference you are going to take y. So that means, so with, by using s you are going to get y. So you are not taking d naught and d1 as reference to get y, you just taking s as your reference to get y. So that's why no need to consider this d naught and d1, you just need to consider selection line. So clearly you just keep in mind that when you are making design of marks, when you are taking truth table for marks, no need to consider input lines, you need to consider selection lines as your input, because your output is not dependent upon the input, your output is clearly dependent upon the selection line. So how a mux is going to provide output means, when selection line is only one line, it may have two combinations. That means selection line may be 0 or 1, these are the two possible combinations for a selection line. If selection line is 0, whatever data is in 0 at port, that will comes to output, that is the process of mux. So if selection line is 1, whatever the value that is in first port, that is coming to output. In the same way, for example, you are having multiple input mux, if selection line value is equivalent to 4, whatever fourth port value is there at input, that is going to output. Like that we are having mux operation. So here if s equal to 0, whatever the value we are having at 0 at port, that is coming to output, that means output is equivalent to d naught. Now in the same way, so when s is equal to 1, when s is equivalent to 1, you are getting so d1 in your output. So here how you are going to represent these values, how you are going to represent the output means, so d naught s bar d1 s is equivalent multiplexer circuit for this. So here y is equivalent to, so output y is equivalent to d naught s bar plus d1 s will be the mux output. So now, so I am taking the logic circuit here, I am taking the logic circuit with selection lines. So this is selection line I taken, and another thing d1 d0, you need to take d1 and d0. So d1 d0 I considered. So to get y, what we need to do is d0 into s bar. So you need complement of this, so you just need complement of this selection line. So when d naught you are connecting, you need to connect s bar. So from here you need to take, so multiplication, I am taking AND gate d1 s, d1 into, I am taking d1 into s, I am taking another AND gate. So these two are added by using an OR gate, so you are providing y. So for any multiplexer, finally you are having OR gate. So this is the circuit integrated with, this is the IC structure. So this is the circuit integrated with AND gates followed by OR gates. So you are getting AND gates, series of AND gates, and all that AND gates outputs are added and you are getting one output. So this is the design of 2 by 1 mux. In the same way we are going to design 4 by 1 mux and 8 by 1 mux, like that. If that is a 4 by 1 mux, so here selection lines may be 2, that we are taking s1 and s0, and here you are taking output as y. So according to the selection lines you are getting output. That we will discuss in the next class, how we will design the remaining muxes, 4 by 1 mux and 8 by 1 mux, and problems related to muxes in gate, that we will discuss in the next classes.